Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Technology. So today in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to create your own mail server in your local area network. So one of my subscribers, his name is Amandeep Singh, who has requested me to make a video on this topic. So without wasting any more time, let's start the video.
So my voice is little bit low because my health is not good today. So sorry for that. So right now I don't have a LAN environment in my local area network. Okay, so I will use here a virtual machine. Okay, so here is my virtual machine. As you can see, I have made this virtual machine as a server, use as a server, and my physical machine I will use as a client machine. Okay, so now what you have to do, you need to first go to your browser and search on the Google. Just open your browser and search in Google HMail server, and after that you have to go to this first link, which is HMail server. And now let me show you. So now, as you can see, here is too many options, so you have to click on this download button and you have to download this latest version. Okay, so here is the downloading is started, as you can see, so you have to wait. So now, as you can see, here is the HMail server. Okay, so just copy the HMail server on your desktop. So now I will check my physical machine and my server machine, both are connected together or not. Just go open your CMD from your client machine and type ping, and on your server machine you have to open CMD and type over the IP config, and the IP is 192.168.0.105. So I will ping this IP 192.168.0.5, and as you can see, ping is not working. So what I have to do is just right click on the network setting on the server machine and click on open and network setting center, and after that here you will get Ethernet. So click on Ethernet, and on the right side corner you will get a network and sharing center. So go over there, and after that close all this tab. Now on the left side corner you will get an option like change advanced sharing center. So you have to scroll down and click on all network over there and make this turn on to sharing anyone, and turn on password protection sharing, turn this off. Now let's see, the ping is working properly, and now I will check my physical machine IP. As you can see, same range IP 192.168.0.100, and this machine IP is 192.168.0.105. So now what I have to do, close all these things. Okay, so now I will install this HMail server. Okay, so just install the HMail server on your server machine and click on next, then I accept the agreement, click on next, then next once again. And if you have already have a database server, then you can use this external database engine. So right now I don't have any database engine on my computer, so I will use a built-in database. Okay, the first one. So after that click on next, then click on next once again, and you have to create a password. Okay, so in this case I will use a password like ASDF1234. That will easy to remember, ASDF1234, and after that click on next and then install. And .NET framework you have to install. If you don't have, click on yes, and after that it will take some time to install all these things, so you have to wait for a few seconds. So now click on download and install these features. So after done, click on close. Now click on finish and make sure that it is checked. And now you will get a window like this. So what you have to do, you need to click on automatic connect on startup, and after that click on connect. And here you have to put your password which you have already set for your HTML server. And now you will get this window. So now you have to add a domain. So in this case, I will use a local host, localserver.com. So I'll put here localserver.com. Okay. So now click on save on the right side corner and you will get a window like this. So if you'll expand the domains and you will get your localserver.com. And now click on accounts. And after that, I will add two accounts over there. Number one is, suppose I have an admin department, so I will create one account for admin department. The password I will use here, same, okay, for the demo purpose. You can use another password, okay, different password for your different account. Now click on save. And after that, I will create one more account. Just click on accounts and after that, click on add. And now I will create an account for accounts, okay, accounts department. So I will put here same password and click on save. So after done, what you have to do, you need to go to your my computer and after that go on the C drive and then Windows folder, and here you need to find a system32 folder. So go under that folder, and under that folder you will get one more folder is called drivers. So go on under that driver folder and then go etc folder, under etc folder, and here you will get one file is called host, okay. So just copy that host file on your desktop, okay, don't drag drop, okay, just copy and paste over there, just right click and paste over there. And now open the notepad on your computer and after that drag drop this host file over there, or you can click on file and then open and go to the desktop and select here all files, and you have to select the host file, okay, or you can drag drop this file on notepad. So now what you have to do, you need to put some IP and domain name over there. So the number one is 127.0.0.1.1. Now press the tab button from your keyboard, okay. Now put here mail dot, my domain is localserver.com, so I'll put here localserver.com. Now press enter, and once again you have to type 127.0.0.1, and after that press tab button from your keyboard once again and then put here localserver.com. now press once again enter and then 127.0.0.1 and then press tab, then put here smtp dot mail dot local server dot com. Now press enter once again and after that put here 127.0.0.1 and then press tab, then here into put pop3 dot mail dot local server.com. Okay, now click on this file button and click on save as. And from your save type, you have to select all file and select that host file, this host file, and after that click on save, or you can press Ctrl and S button from your keyboard. So I will select here host file and click on save. So it's showing like, do you want to replace it? So click on yes. So now just close all these things and once again open the notepad and check it is saved or not. So as you can see, it successfully saved the configuration. Now copy the host file from your desktop, just right click and copy and paste it on your under etc folder. Now click on replace this file in the destination and click on continue. Now open the notepad once again and check this host file is successfully submitted or not. Yes, it is working. So now what you have to do, you need to download one mail client. In this case, I will use a Thunderbird. So just go to the google.com. Sorry, google.com and type here Mozilla Thunderbird and press enter. Now go to the first link and click on this free download, and after that click on save. So now check the view download and click on open folder, and as you can see the Thunderbird is successfully downloaded on my computer, server computer. So now install this Thunderbird setup on your server machine. Now click on yes. After that next, then next, then install. So after install, make sure that it is checked and click on finish. And now you will get this window. So in the window you will get boxes like this. So you have to put your name, email IDs and password. So I will close this one and I will show from the from here. And so click on this setup a new account. Under setup a new account you will get an email account. So click over there and put the name, like I will put here admin, and after that you have to put here the admin email ID. So admin email ID is admin@ localserver.com, and the password ASDF1234. Now click on continue and click on done, and you have to select here I understand the risks. Now click on done. So now as you can see admin is added over there. So now I will add one more account over there. Just click on local folders and click on email ID, and I will add here accounts mail. Okay, and click on localserver.com, and the password I will put here ASDF1234, the same password, because I have set ASDF for this account also. So now click on done, and once again I understand the risks, and then click on done. So both the accounts are added on my Thunderbird email client. Now I will mail each other from the admin department to accounts and accounts department to admin. So now first I will use admin department. So just click over there and click on this write mail. I'll send the mail to accounts. So I will put here accounts@localserver.com. Okay, now subject I will put here test mail from Tricknology, and I'll put here Tricknology test. Now click on send. Now let's see if it's working or not. So on the send item, so if it is not working like this, so just go to the setting option over there and then click on advanced and IP ranges. Check any IP ban over there or not. So it's not banning my IP. So I will mail once again to the accounts department, localserver.com test. So as you can see, if I'll click on get message, so I have getting a two mail on my inbox on the account department. So let's try to open them. I think it is hanged. So just open once again. So click on inbox. As you can see, I am getting a two mail over there. Okay. So you just need to click on synchronize over there. So get a new message, click on, so it will synchronize with your mail. So as you can see, I have get a two mail from admin department. Okay, so now what I have to do is I will mail from the accounts department to admin department. So I will click on reply. So I will put here I got the mail. It's a little bit slow. I got the mail, and after that click on send. Now as you can see, I'm getting one mail on admin department. So now I will access this emails from my client machine. Okay, so here is my client machine. Okay, so here's my client machine. So now first of all I will install this Thunderbird application on my computer, which I have already downloaded on my client machine, as you can see. So click on next, then install, and after that click on finish. So now I will try to add the admin. So accounts department is already added over there, as you can see. So now what I have to do is, so now I will set a admin department mail over there. So click on email and put the name like admin, and the email ID I will put here admin@localserver.com, and the password ASTF1234. Now click on continue, and as you can see it will not work. As you can see, Thunderbird failed to find the setting for your email account. So now what you have to do, you need to go under your C drive, and then Windows, then System32, and then drivers, and then etc. Under etc you will get a host file. So copy that host file on any of your drive. So I will copy under J drive. So now open Notepad and drag drop that host file over there, or you can click on this open and select that host file. So now you have to put the IP address and the mail server name. Okay, so now what you have to do, you need to put the IP address. The IP address is you have to go to your virtual machine, means server machine, and then open the CMD and put over there IP config, and you will get your server machine IP over there. So you have to put the IP, same IP, on your host file on your client machine. Okay, so in this case it is 192.168.0.105. So as you can see, 105. Now press the tab button from your keyboard, and you have to put here mail.localserver.com. Now press enter. Once again you have to put the same IP, and then press tab, then localserver.com, then enter, then tab, sorry, then IP, then tab, then smtp.mail.localserver.com, and press enter, then put the IP address, and then press tab, then pop3.mail.localserver.com. Okay, now save this file over there on your J drive. So let's check is it is saved or not. Yes, it is saved, as you can see. So now what you have to do, you need to copy this host file under your C drive, Windows, System32 driver, then etc. So replace that file, host file, and now let's check once again it is properly saved or not. So as you can see, it's properly saved over there. So now try once again. Now let's try once again, admin@localserver.com, then ASTF1234, then click on continue. I think it will not work again. So let's see. So as you can see, it's not working. So now what you have to do, you need to go to your server machine once again, and here you need to open the run box firewall.cpl, type on your run box firewall.cpl, and click on OK. Sorry, firewall .cpl. So here is the file setting. So, or you can go through your control panel, just go to your start menu, then control panel type over there, and then go to the control panel in your server machine, and then from the right side corner view by, you have to select here large or small icon, and after that you will get Windows Defender Firewall. So click over there and you will get this window, same window. So now what you have to do, you need to click on this turn Windows Firewall on or off. Do it at your own risk, because if anything goes wrong, I will not responsible for that. So because firewall disable your firewall is not a solution, so I will show you guys how to use without disable your firewall, use this mail server. So I will say, show you later, but now I will disable the firewall and click on OK. So now what you have to do, you need to click on retest and let's see it is working or not. So just close this window. Once again I will try and click on email and then admin and password. I'll click on continue. Now let's see it's working or not. Just minimize this. Okay, now click on done. So as you can see it's working. I understand the risk. Click on done. So now the mail is configured. So if I will try to mail from my admin to accounts, let's see it's working or not. Click on write and then try to mail on accounts at the rate localserver.com and email subject should be email from client. So I'll put the same thing over there and click on send button. So now if I'll go to the my server machine, let's see I'm getting any mail over there or not. So as you can see I'm getting one mail over there, email from client, as you can see. So it's working perfectly. Okay, so close all these things. So now so if you want to do these tasks without disable your firewall, then just go to your firewall setting and just turn on the firewall once again. So now click on advanced setting over there and you will get a inbound rule. So you have to click on inbound rule and then click on new rule and you have to unblock the port. Click on port and then here to allow few port over there, which I will give you on my video description, 25, 110, and 143. Okay, specific local port, then click on next, then click on allow the connection and then next, and make sure that all these option is checked, then next, and then h type over there, hmail, and click on finish. Now try once again, I hope it will work. If it is not work, then you have to disable your firewall. Okay, so I hope this small video will really help for you, and please don't forget to click on the subscribe button, like button and share button, and if you have any queries or questions then comments down below. I will see you guys on the next one, next video. Take care.